Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. This is part 2 of the video interfacing the continuous servo motor with STM32. In the previous video we saw how to connect the motor, and how to use the PWM to vary the RPM of the servo motor. Today we will add a potentiometer and a button to our previous project. The potentiometer will be connected via the ADC, and we will use it to vary the RPM of the motor. The button will be used to change the direction of rotation of the motor. I have already covered the basics of the continuous servo in the previous tutorial, so I will not go over them again. Since we will be using the same project that we created in the previous video, let's first import the project to the IDE. Here we have the main file from the previous project. We will now add the ADC and button to this project, so let's open the CubeMX. Here is the connection diagram for this project. On the left side we have the servo motor, and the connection is the same as the previous video. The servo is powered from a 5V battery, and the signal pin is connected to the pin PA8, timer 1 channel 1. I have added a potentiometer to this project, which will be used to vary the RPM of the continuous servo motor. The potentiometer is connected to the 3.3 volts of the MCU, and the output pin is connected to the pin PA1. This is the ADC 1 channel 1 pin. There is a button connected to the pin PA2, which we will use as the external interrupt pin. The button will be used to change the direction of rotation of the motor. Let's enable the ADC 1 channel 1. You can see the pin PA1 got configured as the ADC pin. This is where we have connected the potentiometer to. I am leaving the ADC configuration to default. So there is only one conversion, the continuous conversion mode is disabled, and the sampling time is the least, 1.5 cycles. Potentiometer does not need any specific configuration, so you can set this however you wish. Now configure the pin PA2 as the external interrupt pin. This is where the button is connected. The other pin of the button is connected to 3.3 volts, so we will pull this pin to low by default. When the button is pressed, this pin will be pulled high to 3.3 volts, and the interrupt will trigger. Make sure to enable the external interrupt in the NVIC tab. There is some issue with the clock configuration due to the ADC. We need to reduce the ADC clock to the permitted value. Alright, 10 MHz works fine here. That is all the configuration we need. Click Save to generate the project. We will read the ADC in the blocking mode. Let's write a function to read the ADC value. Here first start the ADC, then poll for the conversion to finish. Then read the ADC value and store it in the variable ADCVal. Finally stop the ADC. The STM32F103C8 has 12-bit ADCs, so the values will range from 0 to 4095. We need to map these values according to our pulse width. The map function here does exactly this. I got this function from the Arduino source code. The parameters of the function are, the variable we want to map, the minimum and maximum values of the variable, and the minimum and maximum values that we want in the output. In the previous video we calculated the minimum and maximum values for the compare register, for which the servo was responding. Therefore we are mapping the ADC value between the limit of 25 and 125. Basically, if the ADC returns 0, the output of this function will be 25, and if the ADC returns 4095, the output of the function will be 125. Now in the main function we have already started the timer in the PWM mode. Inside the while loop, we will fetch the mapped ADC value, and then pass it to the compare register. That is all, I have not added the button yet, but I will add it later. Let's test this part first. Right now the potentiometer is in the middle, therefore the motor is stationary. When the slider is pulled backwards, the AEC value increases towards 4095. So the pulse value is also increasing towards 125, and the RPM of the motor is increasing in the counterclockwise direction. At the extreme end, the AEC value is maximum, so the pulse value is also maximum at 125. The motor is rotating at maximum speed in the counterclockwise direction. Now when the slider moves back towards the center, the ADC value starts decreasing towards 2048, and the motor also slows down in the counterclockwise direction. At this point the pulse value is 75, and hence the motor is stationary. When moving the slider towards the other end, the ADC value further decreases. The pulse value also decreases from 75, and RPM of the motor starts increasing in the clockwise direction. When the slider is at another extreme, the ADC value is near zero, and the pulse value is at 25. The motor is rotating at the maximum RPM in the clockwise direction. So we are able to control the motor using the potentiometer. The AEC values ranging from 0 to 4095 are mapped in the range of 25 to 125, and we can control the RPM, as well as the direction of the motor. Now let's assume that instead of splitting the slider into two halves, I want to control the RPM of the motor for the full slider movement. Basically, I want to vary the pulse from 25 to 75, but for the entire range of the ADC values, from 0 to 4095. And to control the direction of the rotation, I can add a button. Let's define a few variables first. The pulse fix variable will remain constant, and it is set at the middle value of the pulse limit. The variable pulse will be updated in the code. The variable button will keep track of the button pressed count. The pin PA2, where the button is connected, is pulled low by default. When the button is pressed, the pin will be pulled high to 3.3 volts. This will trigger an external interrupt, and the GPIOXD callback will be called. Inside this callback, we will first check if it is called by the pin 2. Then increment the button variable. When the button variable is higher than 2, reset it back to 1. This way, the button variable will be either 1 or 2. We can use these values of the variable to set the direction of the rotation in either clockwise or counter. We also want the motor to rotate in only one direction for the entire range of the potentiometer. So the mapping needs to be done differently. Instead of mapping the ADC value for the entire range of the pulse value, we will only map it to 0 to 50. Let's understand this in detail. When the potentiometer will vary from 0 to 4095, the function will output the value from 0 to 50. Now our fixed pulse variable contains a constant value of 75. So to rotate the motor in clockwise direction, we can subtract the ADC output from this constant value. This will result in the final pulse value ranging from 25 to 75. Similarly, to rotate the motor in the counterclockwise direction, we can add the ADC value to the fixed pulse value. And that will result in the final pulse value ranging from 75 to 125. Inside the while loop, we will check the value of the button variable. If it is 1, then add the ADC map value to the pulse fixed value, so as to rotate the motor in the counterclockwise direction. Otherwise, if it is 2, then subtract the ADC map value from the pulse fixed value, so as to rotate the motor in the clockwise direction. That is all we need here. Let's build and flash the project to the board. Right now the button value is 0, and if I vary the slider, there is no rotation. Now let's press the button. You can see the motor is rotating in the clockwise direction. And if I vary the slider position, the RPM of the motor also varies accordingly. When the button is pressed again, the direction of rotation has been changed. And varying the slider now increases the RPM in the counterclockwise direction. When the button is pressed again, the direction is switched back clockwise. So we can control the RPM of the motor using the potentiometer. I have demonstrated two different ways of doing it, and you can use whichever suits you better. This is it for the video. I hope everything was clear. You can download the code from the link in the description. Leave comments in case of any doubt. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.